Hello friends and namaskar. So welcome to one more new episode of Spoken English, and I hope you people are doing well and following our English program. I would like to thank all those people who are calling us and sending us SMS regarding Spoken English classes, and I'm so happy to know about this. And you know what? It is really encouraging for me to present new episodes and then new topic every day. Okay? So, these days we are learning about verbs, as you know. If you are watching us for the first time, well, we are learning about grammar. And grammar, as you know, it's an integral part of spoken English. You ought to know grammar, and grammar would clarify all your doubts and you would be speaking flawless and correct English. So, अंग्रेजी व्याकरण भी सीखना उतना ही जरूरी है क्योंकि इससे आपको जो क्लैरिटी है, जो थॉट्स में क्लैरिटी है, उसमें कोई भी गलती नहीं होगी और फिर आप सही अंग्रेजी बोल पाएंगे. तो हम लोग बहुत सारे वर्ब सुने हैं, जैसे बी फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब. अब ये बी फॉर्म, बी जो वर्ब होता है उसी का एक थ्री फॉर्म्स हम देखेंगे और उसका जो पास्ट टेंस है उसे भी हम ध्यान करेंगे. तो आइए देखेंगे ये बी फॉर्म क्या है. तो बी फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब के लिए सबसे पहले एम, उसके बाद इज, फिर आर. और इसी का पास्ट टेंस हम देखते हैं. एम और इज का है वॉज और आर का क्या है वर. राइट? सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट दीज थिंग्स ओनली, बट अकॉर्डिंग टू द पर्सन हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू बी यूज्ड. कर्ता के हिसाब से आप इन क्रियाओं का प्रयोग कैसे करेंगे. Okay, so let's see the first person how it is being used and then how this past tenses are also formed, right? So here is the person, the subject. Okay, maan lijiye first person, and iske saath aap lagayenge am in present, and पास्ट में आप लगाएंगे वॉस. सेकेंड क्या है यू, यू के साथ होगा आर, इसका पास्ट टेंस वर, वी आर, इसका भी पास्ट टेंस वेर, दे आर. ओके, इसका भी पास्ट टेंस वर. नाउ he, she, it और किसी का भी नाम, इनके साथ आप लगाएंगे is, जिसका past tense है was. अब आप ध्यान से सुनिए, ये जो present tense है वर्तमान की बातें करने के लिए या फिर जो भी actions अभी हो रहा है उन actions को express करने के लिए, to denote those actions we'll be using the first form, that is the present form. Okay, whatever has happened and you are going to repeat that, and that situation will be using what, the past form of the verbs. Okay, so you should never get confused, because in the first person it is always am, okay, and then with the second it is always are, and then with the third person it is always is, and this is the past form of that. Now let us see some examples with it. What examples? I am, okay, I was, you are, you were, we are, we were, they are, they were, he is, he was, she is, she was, it is, it was. Okay, now I am very tired. I के साथ आपने क्या लगाया, am. Now इसी को past tense में कहेंगे तो I was very tired yesterday, और I was very tired in the morning. जरूरी नहीं है, past tense means it is only जो हुआ यस्टरडे या डे बिफोर यस्टरडे, इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. पास्ट टेंस मींस जस्ट what has happened. Suppose you are talking in the afternoon. If you talk something about what happened in the morning, that becomes past only because morning is over. You are in afternoon. So you can say, I was tired last night. I was tired in the morning. Now I'm feeling fresh. Okay? So, am and tired. Okay? Now, aur am ke saath yahan pe tired. So, yahan pe tired hai. So, tired is the main verb that you have been using. And then, for the past tense, you will be using what? I was. Okay? And then, one more example. I'm busy now. I am busy now. So, again here, I ke saath you used am. If it is past, then you can use was. But you should not use are. Theek hai? I are very tired. I are busy now. Okay? This are is not used there. So, every time with the first person I, you are supposed to use what? Only am. And the past tense is was. Okay? So, now frame a few sentences by yourself using I. Okay? I feel excited. Okay? Then I am writing now. So, am. Am can be used in the simple past as well as in the past continuous. Okay? Otherwise, simple present and present continuous. Matlab, jo aadat ki baatein hain. For example, I am busy now. So, ye continuous ko hi jataata hai. Lekin kabhi kabhi yahan pe ing bhi laga sakte hain. Lekin wo context ke hisab se aapko karna hai. To aaiye dekhenge you ke saath. You, okay. Kya hai? You look smart. Okay? You look smart. Is the sentence correct? Absolutely correct. When it is simple present. Ab dekhiye yahan pe. Are agar aapko lagana hai yahan pe. To you are. Then ye look ke saath aap kya lagayenge? ING lagayenge. You are looking smart. Now, isi ko past tense mein you were looking smart. You ke saath are. Past tense ho to were. You ke saath aap is nahi lagayenge. You is very smart. Okay? Or you smart. No, this is the right form of the verb that will connect the sentence and give you a meaningful sentence. Okay? So, you are looking smart. You were looking smart. Now, let us start with we. We are going out. Are jo hai continuity ko darshata hai. Yani ek action shuru hua ya fir action jo hone wale hain, wo ya fir jo gat raha hai. Usko darshata hai. So, we are going, ing, okay? Otherwise, it is only what? We go out. We go out, fine. But now, when you are going out and you are telling, where are you going? Okay? They ke saath ek laga lenge. They are out of station. Again are. So, they is nahi hoga ya they was bhi nahi hoga. Again, if you want to have past tense here, you can put what? Were. Followed? Now, let us start with the third person. With the third person, how are you going to frame sentences? Whenever you are using the third person, it is always the helping verb, the be form of the verb is is. He is a nice boy. Is, was. He are is absolutely wrong. Okay? You ke saath are legega. Not he are or she are or it are. Okay? Now, she is a dancer. She is a dancer. Past tense mein, she was a dancer. अब मान लीजिए, अब जब आप खुद की बात करते हैं तो आप फर्स्ट पर्सन आई के साथ शुरू करेंगे. जब आप अपने बच्चे के बारे में किसी को सुना रहे हैं या फिर अपने घर वालों के बारे में आप किसी और को सुना रहे हैं तो वो थर्ड पर्सन हो जाते हैं. तब आप पूरा क्या लगाएंगे? ईजी लगाएंगे हर प्रोनाउन के साथ और उसका पास्ट टेंस में वॉज. जैसे कि इट वॉज क्राइंग इन द नाइट. इट वॉज क्राइंग इन द नाइट. It was a tasty dish. Okay? तो और अगर इसमें past tense है तो time is also mentioned. If it is a past tense, it means something has already happened. It was a tasty dish. So present में क्या होगा? It is a tasty dish. Followed? So you keep using them present and past, present and past, then you would come to know the usages. These were the usages for positive sentences or a sentences that does not have any negativity. Okay, let us see another list of sentences where we can use in a negative way. Okay, so keep remembering am, is, are past tenses, was and were. Okay. And one more thing, what you, how you can remember is, all the time you are supposed to say that I am, you are, he is. Okay, so say I am, you are, we are, they are, and then he is, she is, it is. So if you keep this table in your mind, you will never commit any mistake. इस टेबल को, इस तालिका को जो आपने अभी थोड़ी देर पहले देखा था, इसको अगर आप दिमाग में रखेंगे तो आपसे कभी गलतियां नहीं होगी जहां पर आप बी फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब यूज करते हैं. ओके, नाउ एज आई वॉज टेलिंग यू, वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट? नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेस. आइए देखेंगे नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेस. नाउ नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, she is not, she is not interested in me. ये is not हम पूरी तरह से मतलब खुल के लिखेंगे when you are writing, but इनका short forms भी हो सकता है. Short forms जब आप use करते हैं तब वो क्या हो जाता है? बिल्कुल spoken form हो जाता है. उस स्पोकन फॉर्म को आप स्पोकन में ही रहने दीजिए, आप उसको बिल्कुल रिटन फॉर्म में ना लाएं. लाइक शी इजंट इंटरेस्टेड, शी इजंट इंटरेस्टेड इन मी. सो व्हेन यू स्पीक यू विल बी यूजिंग द कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड फॉर्म्स. ओके, ये जो संकुचित शब्द हैं इसका प्रयोग आप करते हैं व्हाइल यू आर टॉकिंग, बट व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग you have to expand and write. Now let us see one more example. I am not coming today. Okay, now iska short form kya ho sakta hai? I am not coming today. Amn't coming. आप इस भाषा का भरपूर उपयोग जो कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड फॉर्म्स हैं एसएमएस में कर सकते हैं आप, क्योंकि आपको समय भी कम लगेगा और स्पेस भी कम लगेगा और जल्दी से जल्दी आप टाइप भी कर पाएंगे. लेकिन वे इफ यू डोंट यूज दिस अपोस्ट्रोफी ओके ऑन टॉप देन द होल मीनिंग चेंजेस एंड इट इज नॉट अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड फॉर्म. लेट अस सी अ फ्यू मोर एग्जाम्पल, अ फ्यू मोर एग्जाम्पल. व्हाट आर द फ्यू मोर एग्जाम्पल्स यू कैन सी? They are not business people. short form, they are not business people. Short form, they aren't. They aren't business people. Okay? Now, uske baad you. You are not telling the truth. What is the sentence? You are not telling the truth. Short form again, aren't. You aren't telling the truth. So friends, like this only, in your daily context, in your daily walk of life, your daily actions, whatever you do, pick up these sentences and make negative forms and keep practicing it. Because if you practice, then only you will be understanding the negative and the contracted forms of those negative sentences. Am I clear? Let us see the next part of the usage of am, is and are. Aye dekhenge in sahayak kriyaon ke saath, is be form ke verb ke saath, aap questions wala sentence kaise banate hain. Chaliye. Ab maan lijiye ek sentence hai. He is ready. He is ready to go. He is ready to go. He ke saath is lagaya. Pehle aaya subject, fir aaya verb aur uske baad object. Theek hai? To ye subject, verb, uske baad rest of the sentence. Ab isko aapko question mein badalne ke liye just aap is jagah ko change kar dijiye. Ye yahan aayega aur uske baad ye yahan. To pehle question word is, fir he ready to go. Ab, is this sentence correct? If you say it is correct, you are wrong. And if you say the sentence is wrong, then you are absolutely correct. Now, if the sentence is wrong, what is wrong with the sentence then? The wrong is, I forgot to put a question mark. So, with the question word in the beginning and a question sign at the end will make the sentence as a question sentence, interrogative sentence. So, isme aapne samanya vakya mein pehle hi lagaya, uske baad aaya is. Lekin jagah ko badal dene se wo sentence kya ban jayega? Prashnavachak vakya ban jayega ya fir use question mark sentence bhi kehte hain. To chaliye dosto, kuch aur sentences bhi hum dekh lete hain. Abhi she ke saath ek laga lo. She is very talented. Okay, ab iska question mein kaisa hoga? Pehle aayega is, uske baad jayega she. Is she very talented? Answer hoga yes or no mein. Iske baad aap pura sentence continue kar sakte hain ya fir no ke baad aap pura sentence continue kar sakte hain. To is tarike se aap kya karte hain, kuch sentences ko hum question sentence mein badal sakte hain, provided that first the question sentence starts with a question word and ends with a question mark like this sentence. Okay, so one more time, I just want to remind you, whenever you are asking a question, especially in spoken form, there should be some change in your tone. Okay, jaise I'll read the first sentence for you. He is ready to go. He is ready to go. Now, sentence jab wo question mein badlega, and since there is a question mark, the stress should be there. There should be a rise in your tone. So, how are you going to raise your tone here? Is he ready to go? So, you are stressing on ease and then at the end. So, change in the tone will make question sentence, provided it has a question word and a question mark. So, he is ready to go. It's not a correct way to read it out. He is ready to go. Is he ready to go? Next, She is very talented. Is she very talented? So again, there is a rise and fall in the tone. Okay. So whenever you are speaking English, it is very important that you create the expressions and then talk. So you give out an expression while talking. So don't be like, you know, monotony, the same sentence going ever and ever. According to the situation, you have to raise your tone, change your tone, and sometimes it is flat, sometimes it is high, and sometimes it is low. Okay? So let's see a few more examples of interrogative sentences. Now let's see a few more sentences. Is he okay or all right? Ab iska actual sentence kya hai? He is all right. Ab isi ko humne sentence mein kaisa badla? This. There is a change here. Understand? So is he okay or is he all right? Yes, he is all right. Or no, he is not all right. Okay. So one more example. I am sick of doing the same work. I'm sick of doing the same work. अब यहां पे आपको ध्यान देना बहुत जरूरी है. So question is, am I sick of doing the same work? Okay. Sometimes this am I question, you know, you put this question for yourself when you're talking for yourself. Ki aise bhi kabhi mumkin hai jab aap apne aap se baat karte ho? Yes, it is possible. You are doing some work, you are very tired, you are getting fed up, or you are very enjoying it. You talk to yourself. At that time, when you question yourself, this is the formation. Okay? Am I sick of doing this work? Okay? Am I really good? Somebody came and told you, what? You are really looking very beautiful. Am I really beautiful? Am I? So you are questioning yourself, is it? Now, someone comes and says, you are simply awesome. Am I really awesome? So you question yourself. So when you ask something about yourself, it is more appropriate. Am I? Okay. So now, one more form is there. When someone says, look here, you are going today. Am I? That's it. Even that is also a question. So that those sorts of questions we'll be seeing in tag questions. Okay. But here, let's follow the full sentence. Okay. So now go to the next level now. Next, I'm going to give you a list of sentences and you're going to tell me whether the sentence is correct or wrong. Okay. If it is correct, why? And if it is wrong, why? These are the few sentences that I have written on the blackboard. Now, you need to tell me which sentences are correct and which sentences are wrong. So, if it is correct, why it is correct? If it is wrong, why it is wrong? Shall we see the first sentence? Okay. What is the first sentence? I am thirsty. Is it correct? Yes or no? It is correct. Why? I ke saath am hai. Theek hai? I ke saath am. Next. You are kind. Is the sentence correct? Boliye. Yes or no? It is correct. Because with you, it is are. So, correct sentence. Now, next. I hope you are getting the answers. Next one. He are not sad. He are not sad. Is the sentence correct? Thinking? See, what did I say? I am, you are, he, she, it, is. Exactly. So, he, are nahin. He, is. Not, sad. Got it? Now see, if you have got the right answer, fantastic, keep going. Now, next one. She am tall. What is this? She am tall. Is this sentence correct? As this was wrong, this is also wrong. What is wrong in this? This am should not be there. Because maine abhi bola tha na, he is, she is, it is. So, she is tall. Okay? See the next sentence. Is they running? Is they running? Now, they ke saath maine kya bola tha? I am, okay? You are, we are, they are. So, I am, you are, they are, we are. So, here, they ke saath is nahi hoga. Kya hoga? Are. Theek hai? Are they running? Okay? Next. Are you ready? Is the sentence correct? Exactly correct. Just now I said you ke saath are. So, this sentence is correct. Ab aap apne aap se hi dekh lijiye kitna sahi tha. और 6 में से आपको कितने मार्क्स मिले और ज्यादा अभ्यास के लिए लगातार हमारे कार्यक्रम देखते रहिए और बहुत सारे न्यूज़पेपर्स और कॉमिक्स पढ़िए ताकि आपको सही यूसेज का अनुमान लगे और फिर पता लगे ठीक है सो विद दिस वी एंड आवर एपिसोड टुडे एंड विल बी मीटिंग यू इन अनदर एपिसोड विद अ न्यू टॉपिक टिल देन टेक केयर एंड गुड बाय